Vamos a moderar esto, prensa.
Saludos de la prensa. De parte de la prensa de Nueva York, yo soy dominicano, americano, nacido aquí, no sé mucho de la política de allá, pero espero que la prensa de aquí te dé el apoyo. No lo dan mucho cuando ven como tú estabas hablando ahorita. Mi pregunta, dos preguntitas, pero rápido, yo sé que hay muchas preguntas. La primera es que en los haitianos allá, ley y orden, ¿tú piensas que tú vas a trabajar fuertemente para que las personas que son haitianos allá, no como tú dijiste, no que está en contra de ellos, pero la persona que está ilegal en la migratoria, tú vas a trabajar fuerte en eso?
Absolutamente. Nosotros vamos a cerrar la frontera, vamos a parar, vamos a poner un cese absoluto categórico a la migración haitiana. Incluso he dicho y reitero aquí esta noche que nosotros vamos a reformar la fuerza castrense. O sea que el ejército se va a dignificar. Pero luego de eso, nosotros vamos a mandar un batallón entero, completo, que cubra toda la frontera. Y el primer oficial que incurra en la venta de nuestra soberanía, dejando pasar por Chile a un nacional haitiano, se va a someter por traición.
Okay. ¿Usted va a trabajar con el gobierno de aquí, de Donald Trump? Sabe que hay mucha controversia con las personas que son ilegales aquí y lo que está pasando. ¿Tú vas a trabajar fuertemente con el presidente Donald Trump? Porque hay mucha controversia ahora mismo. ¿Tú piensas trabajar fuertemente con el presidente de aquí?
Yo le digo, yo apoyé al presidente Trump en su campaña, porque yo entiendo que uno tiene que ser coherente. Y en estos momentos, el problema mayor que nosotros tenemos en la República Dominicana es el tema migratorio. Y cuando yo vi la coherencia del presidente Trump en lo que es el tema migratorio de los Estados Unidos, porque nosotros no podemos decir en República Dominicana tenemos el derecho de construir un muro con los Estados Unidos, no. Si nosotros queremos un muro y queremos abogarnos de ese derecho que nos faculta nuestra condición de país libre y soberano, de cerrar esa frontera, los Estados Unidos tiene ese mismo derecho.
Nosotros lo tenemos también.
Supporting Donald J. Trump and what is happening with immigration. There's a lot of controversies here. You're going to be supporting the president here on immigration, illegal immigration.
I think the United States has every right to do what it needs to do to solidify its immigration policies.
Last thing, DACA. How do you feel about DACA? That's a lot of controversy there. A lot of the politicians here, there's 800,000 folks that are DACA. How do you feel about that? Do you feel it's in Congress's hands? What's your opinion on DACA? Last question.
Listen, I think Donald Trump's administration is looking for other ways to solve the issue with DACA. I'm not 100% positive on what's going to happen in the end, but I think, listen, we've got a lot of people here that have taken advantage of the system and they continue to take advantage of the system. You know, and we pay taxes. I've been working here for the past 27 years. I pay taxes, and I want my taxes to go where they need to go here in the United States, you know? So I think the United States has as much right to create laws that are going to advocate for the good of the American people and the taxpayers of this country. You know, so I do support the policies that Donald Trump is doing in terms of migration. And we're going to see in the end what's going to happen, because there's a lot of hearsay going back and forth, and people are coming up with one idea and another idea, and they're trying to twist the stories around. We have to wait and see. We have to give the guy a chance. You know, the neoliberal press has been on him since the day he went into office in January. Right now, we have to give the guy an opportunity, cut him a break, you know, and let him see if he can get things going the way he's wanted to do it from the very beginning, and they haven't given him the opportunity to do it. I'm somebody that believes firmly in giving people the benefit of the doubt. Until you prove otherwise, you have to give the person the benefit of the doubt. He's, you know, so far the economy's booming here in the United States. The stock market is up, and all of these conditions that were affecting so perniciously the American industry have been turned around. So he's doing something right. You know, but he's got a huge opposition. Number one, the fourth power in the country, which is the press. So, you know, you got to give the guy a break and see what happens in the end. I support the United States position as a country to be able to pass migratory laws and do whatever they need to do to control the migration, which is uncontrolled here in the United States. So, absolutely.
Thank you. Yes.
Participando aquí con nosotros, usted ha tocado prácticamente